Good morning, Saugus. I'm Sean Pacheco.
And I'm Connor Gilbertson.
I'm Kaysen Markoff.
I'm Marisa Lamas.
And I'm Nina Ripple.
I'm Priscilla Pignato.
I'm Ryan Harris.
I'm Mikhail Tizai.
And I'm Matt Hollenbach.
I'm Sophia Card.
I'm Nolan Hodge.
And I'm Kenzie Mustafa. This is SNF.
Today I'm going to be showing you how to make mini strata egg muffins.
Italian seasoning, salt, and feta cheese together. Top it off with a slice of basil.
What are your hopes for 2023?
I hope that every senior graduates.
Bring any baby powder.
Nina, do your homework. You don't have to wait a second, it's fine.
Should I go with the booty shorts, or should I wear the really skinny jeans?
You should wear basketball shorts.
Well, Saugus, it's New Year once again, so we thought we'd ask you what you're looking forward to in 2023.
Yeah, life is just really great, and yeah.
hold on.
That's all for today. I'm Nolan Hodge. Stay tuned for SNF Radio and Saugus today.
And I'm Kenzie Mustafa. Don't forget that this week's schedule will be slightly different because of open house on Thursday.
Good morning, Saugus. I'm Sean Pacheco, and today is Friday, May 26th.
And I'm Marisa Lamas. This is SNN. Let's start off today's show by going to Mrs. Peterson-Henry with this year's last principal's message.
Good morning, everyone. I hope you are all having a great week. Today is your last day of regularly scheduled classes. Finals begin when you return next week on Tuesday. Please make time to prepare for your finals this weekend. This is really the home stretch, and I want you all to finish strong. We are super excited for graduation coming up next week, but at the same time, we are really going to miss our seniors. Speaking of graduation, the graduation seating list is available outside of the admin office by the Centurion statue. Please take a look today so you know where you will be seated, either on the home side or the visitor side. You should also get your seat number so you know where you will be in line and where you will be seated during graduation. Taking a picture of this is a great way to ensure that you don't forget. 5 days until graduation. As you probably already know, Monday is Memorial Day, and there is no school. Memorial Day is a time to honor and remember the brave men and women who have made the ultimate sacrifice while serving in the armed forces. Consider taking some time this week to reflect and honor our heroes. This is my last SNN address of the year. Study hard for finals and have a safe and enjoyable summer. And don't forget, we have high expectations for you, and we are here to support you. A centurion is someone who finishes the school year strong and looks for ways to be connected to our campus. Have a great Friday and a safe weekend.
Thanks, Mrs. Peterson-Henry. In lieu of our usual fact of the day, we thought we'd give our last pieces of advice for Saugus students as we graduate.
Do you know what a countdown is? I was like holding a three.
Only educational lessons, but also life lessons. Most students come into high school with an understanding that teachers will be here for only 4 years. However, in my case at Saugus, the teachers are more than just teachers, but friends that last longer than 4 years. I never forget in the beginning of my junior year when Mr. Williams told me one thing that changed my entire perspective on career building. Show me your friends and I'll show you your future. There are countless points of advice that teachers here at Saugus can give, but in the big picture, you realize that the teachers care for you, not as a student, but as a family member. That's something I'll definitely miss here. To the staff and students at Saugus High School, I appreciate the countless amount of support the community has shown over the past 4 years, and my hope is that the upcoming generations take the opportunity to connect with their community. Build a new you.
Do away with all the meaningless boundaries we put up, because over my past 4 years, with all the struggles, all the tragic events we faced, I found that the way we united together as sort of one large class, it made the events a lot easier to deal with, to get through. And I think that sort of having otherwise those very typical barriers, that really only harms us. And it's just better to stand up to any event or anything that happens as one group than as a bunch of smaller little groups.
I think the biggest piece of advice that I leave to Saugus students is to look ahead and just be excited about your future, be excited for what awaits. Instead of procrastinating, get things done early. I know we all procrastinate, it's terrible, but it gets the job done is what we say. But I think if we look forward to other things, we can get excited about college applications and jobs and internships and other things that we strive to do in the future. And if we work on them now, then it'll be just that much easier when we get there.
I guess my advice to everyone who's staying here for another year is, every time you get like an idea that something might be a cool thing to do, to just try it, you know? But like, especially when it comes to doing things with other people, like joining a new class or a club or something like that, I feel like those are the types of things that sometimes are difficult to get yourself to do. But when you go out of your way to try something new and meet new people, you end up forming a lot of connections that you didn't have before. I'm really happy that I spent the time going out of my way to meet a lot of people and to get to know a lot of people and to have a lot of different friends from different cliques around campus, because they all teach you something. And then you miss the place. You miss this place a lot more when you have all those connections. And it makes it a lot sweeter when you finally graduate, because you get to, you have more people to hug and say goodbye to. It lets you know that you had a good 4 years and it was worth it.
We've truly learned so much over the past 4 years, so we hope you take our advice. But good luck in all of your endeavors. We truly wish you luck. Please stand for the flag salute.
Please stand. Place your right hand over your heart. Ready, begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may now be seated.
If you submitted your picture for the We're Going Places senior sweatshirt photo, be on the lookout for ordering information within the next week. Mr. Fricke will be sending an email to both students and parents with directions on how to order the group photo from O'Connor Photography. Habitat for Humanity's final build day will be this Sunday from 4:30 to 7 at Saugus. The project will be a cleanup of the campus and minor renovations before graduation and the start of summer. The day is open to all students of Saugus, regardless of age. There will be a mandatory meeting in room P1605 today for all those interested in attending. For more information, see Mr. Klopfel or email him at the email listed below.
Now, let's go to Kaysen Markoff and Connor Gilbertson with today's Saga Sports Update.
Thanks, Marisa. Good morning, Saugus. I'm Kaysen Markoff.
And I'm Connor Gilbertson. And yes, I am standing on a box with today's Saugus Sports Update.
Very true. Registrations for athletic clearances and sports summer camps are open at the links listed. Students must have an up-to-date physicals and athletic clearances completed in order to participate in any sports on campus.
Make sure to get that done. Are you looking for a place to work out without the cost? Look no further. Planet Fitness is offering the High School Summer Pass program for all high schoolers between 14 and 19. You will have access to work out at any Planet Fitness location for free. For more information, use the link listed.
That's all for us. Now, let's go to Mr. Williams and Gia Sanchez with a tribute to one of our retirees this year, Mr. Jeffris.
Back in 2000, when I got my Durango, I bought it brand new. It was the first four-wheel drive I ever had. And me and Jeffris went out four-wheel driving with two other students that we shared. Went up to San Francisco Canyon. And I'd never four-wheel driven before. And I had this brand new SUV and was climbing on the side of a mountain. And I thought for sure we were going to roll over. Ken kind of scared at the time. I kind of really wanted to do it, but I think he wanted to do it a little bit more because he can't take his old 1960 Corvette Stingray out four-wheel driving. One time we were doing a poetry read, and one of the things that we were doing was acting out some of the things in the poem. And in the portables, if you stamp your feet, it sounds like earthquake. And Jeffris comes out of his room and says, "Did you feel that? There was an earthquake." And my entire class just broke up and thought it was the funniest thing in the world. No, it was us.
Thank you, Mr. Jeffris, for making my senior year memorable, and I hope you have a great retirement.
Next year and the years after, you may be gone, but you will not be forgotten. Happy trails, my friend.
Thank you, Mr. Jeffris, for everything you've done for the students of this campus and for all the hard work you've put in. Happy retirement.
Textbook returns in the library continue this week through June 1st. All senior textbooks and book finds are due today at noon.
Now let's go to our scholarship news.
The Women in California Leadership Scholarship Competition works to empower women and enhance the lives of women and girls. They award 100 scholarships worth $3,000 and one $10,000 scholarship. To be eligible, applicants must be female, have a 2.5 overall GPA, and must be a graduating high school senior with written proof of acceptance at an accredited institution of higher learning. To apply, see the link in the Senior Google Classroom or use the link listed below. The deadline to submit an application is next Wednesday, May 31st.
The Epic Flight Academy in Florida is offering various scholarships to current juniors and seniors to attend their flight training or aviation maintenance programs in Florida after graduating. The link to apply is available in the Junior and Senior Counseling Google Classrooms. The deadline to apply is October 1st.
The Big Sun organization is offering a $500 scholarship to help young athletes succeed in their academic pursuits. All student athletes are eligible to apply, regardless of the sport they play, and they must be a current high school senior. To apply, use the Senior Google Classroom site or the link listed below. that's all for today. Stay tuned for SNN Radio and Saugus Today. To all those taking finals next week, good luck and congratulations to all seniors on completing yours.
Signing off for the final time, I'm Sean Pacheco.
I'm Marisa Lamas.
I'm Kaysen Markoff.
And I'm Connor Gilbertson.
We here at SNN would like to thank you so very much for being a wonderful audience the past 4 years. We've been through thick and thin together, and we can't thank you enough for sticking with us throughout. Cherish these moments, because you're never going to be able to live them again. So it's best to live in the moment while you can. Have a great day, a great weekend, a great summer, and SNN will see you next year.
I'm Sean Pacheco, and today is Tuesday, October 15th, the second day of Rocktober 80s Week.
And I'm Connor Gilbertson, and this is SNN.
I'm Marisa Lamas.
I'm Kaysen Markoff.
I'm Sean Pacheco.
And I'm Marisa Lamas.
I'm Kaysen Markoff with today's Saugus Sports Update.
And I'm Connor Gilbertson. Have a great day, and we'll see you tomorrow.